Hello everyone, this is Tim, Collections Manager of the Bell Museum Herbarium. As the days grow longer and warmer, we botanists start to think about seeing plants as they emerge from their winter dormancy. This is an act of optimism, because in the northern latitudes, it's been a long time since we've seen any green, and it's hard to imagine that delicate wildflowers could possibly have survived the past few months in the iron-hard frozen ground. But somehow they do survive, and the Big Woods diorama at the Bell Museum illustrates this springtime reawakening. The Bell's dioramas date from the early to mid-20th century. They reflect a shift in the role of natural history museums from the private realm of hoarding 18th century aristocrats to the more democratic education and scientific institutions of the 19th and 20th centuries. The dioramas were designed to present an immersive ecological story. They provide an opportunity for the observer to take a virtual walk through a habitat and see a slice of nature that's hard to witness firsthand. For example, it's unlikely any of us will ever actually see wood ducklings leaping from the safety of their nest into the unknown world below. The dioramas also provide motivation for us to get out into nature. At this time of year, the Big Woods diorama is particularly inspiring. The background, painted by Francis Lee Jacques, sets the stage for migrating songbirds and, of course, those ducklings. But from a botanist's perspective, the real highlights are the wildflowers on the forest floor. In fact, this is the most botanically rich of the Bell's dioramas, with at least 24 plant species. Many of Minnesota's classic spring flowers are featured. These plants complete their life cycles before the canopy has fully leafed out and closed off nearly all the sunlight. In the diorama, we can see three species of trillium, including the large-flowered trillium, the nodding trillium, and the smallest of Minnesota's trillium species, the rare snow trillium. This is a true spring ephemeral that appears just after the snow has melted and is mostly gone once the tree canopy closes. Another ephemeral in the diorama is Dutchman's breeches, with its delicate and unusual bloomer-shaped white or pale pink flowers. And you can also see bloodroot, a member of the poppy family with red sap that oozes from any wound in the stem or leaf. In fact, the Latin name of the genus, Sanguinaria, means of or pertaining to blood. But the highlight of this diorama is the Minnesota trout lily. It's one of only a few plant species that is endemic to the state. In other words, it's found nowhere else in the world except a few locations in the southeastern part of the state. This true Minnesota original was discovered in 1870 in Rice County by Mary B. Hedges, a botany instructor at St. Mary's School. The Minnesota trout lily is smaller than its more widespread cousin, the white trout lily, and normally it has only 5 petals rather than 6. Before European settlement, the Big Woods covered a large area of south-central Minnesota. Since then, it has been chopped and fragmented. Invasive species have established in many places, and an overabundance of white-tailed deer seem to have a particular taste for spring wildflowers. Introduced earthworms are also found in almost all Big Woods habitat, and these have had a surprisingly negative impact on our native plants. Still, it is possible to see some beautiful examples of Big Woods habitat at Nostrand Woods or Succotar Lake State Parks, or Wolfsfeld Woods or Wood Rill Scientific and Natural Areas. So, there is still a reason for optimism when you see those first signs of spring emerging from the ground to begin another cycle of life.